1986年7至9月，神话般的宝库终于在三星堆遗址打开了。7月下旬，1号祭祀坑经过10个多昼夜的连续发掘，挖到1米6深处，就出现了这样便坑的器物。1986年8月中旬，距1号坑约20米的地方又发现第二个大型祭祀坑，清完填土就出现满坑的象牙堆积，大小60多根，长约1米左右。只有蜀王贵族才能拥有这样众多的财富。
The artifacts excavated back then are now placed in a museum, which attracts countless tourists from home and abroad to visit every day.
用黄金来制作大面具，只见于古蜀文化，并且它的这个制型工艺应该是同期中国最高超的。带有金面罩和没有带金面罩的，可以说和他们的世俗的权利和宗教文化里边的象征这两个维度，都是表达了它的等级、层位、等次的差别，可以说反映出古蜀人对黄金的这种重视，甚至可以进一步说，他们古蜀文化对黄金的重视超过了青铜器，是这个图案它有象征意义，可能表达的是对古蜀的某个重大事件的记录。
As a young scientist, I'm curious about the technologies that archaeologists use to investigate the age and elemental composition of exponents. In this regard, I went to visit Gold and Silver Emperor Lu Haizi at the Cultural Relics Protection Center, Sichuan Institute of Heritage and Archaeology, to learn the which techniques he used to study and repair artifacts after excavation.
这一件鸟形金饰件和这个目前暂定名排除为这个金器，因为还是不知道它具体是什么。对，它俩在刚出土的时候情况也都比较相似，基本都是对折扭曲，然后缠绕折叠。各种这种形变吧，或者说这种变形，让它这个混合在一块儿。然后他们两件，它当时被这个鸟形金饰片折叠比较严重，因为它特别特别薄。
During the first century, gold was used in Azerbaijan for medical purposes to treat wounds that will be afflicted by magic potions. From that time, gold has become the most integral and inevitable part of Azerbaijan culture. The Chinese have made many shapes with gold. For example, cabbage in Chinese harmonic is bai sai, which means to get rich. It's also made into some animal shapes.Such as Chinese dragons, elephants, and etc. All of these, whether in the shape of plants or animals, are symbolic of blessing in China. this day, thousands of visitors are still amazed by exquisite gold mass and a gold scepter in Sanctuary Museum, marveling at the ancient and mysterious Sanctuary civilization. Also, there are still many mysteries waiting to be uncovered, and we have no way to know the specific purpose of these artifacts. It seems their story will eventually be passed by generations. On the day when we clear all the mysteries of Sanctuary, we'll look back and realize this is history.